I've been dabbling in DIY electronics for several years now, but during this time I mostly worked with projects that use so-called through-hole components. They're called through-hole because most components have long legs, such as this transistor here, and these legs typically go through holes on a PCB, like so, and then they are soldered from the backside of the PCB. Most through-hole components are relatively large and easy to solder. That's why most hobbyists actually use through-hole components in their projects. In contrast to DIY projects, most industrial and commercial products use so-called surface mount components. I will use this old PCI video card as an example. So as you can see, all those tiny things on the surface of the PCB, they are resistors and capacitors and inductors and ICs and all the other parts. They are soldered to the pads that are located on the surface of the PCB, and most surface mount parts are really tiny, and the pitch or the distance between individual contacts is usually pretty small, which makes them rather challenging to solder by hand. Unfortunately, through-hole parts seem to be a dying breed simply because there is not enough demand for them to sustain production. For example, recently I needed some BC560 and BC550 transistors, and it turned out that they had been discontinued by all reputable manufacturers. And at the same time, the surface mount counterparts, BC860 and BC850, are still in production and readily available. And this really surprised me because BC560 and BC550 are, or probably were, the most popular low-noise audio transistors in the world, and if parts such as those are getting discontinued, it means that less popular components have even less chance of staying in production. And unfortunately, this means that people who are interested in DIY electronics really have to learn surface mount soldering. This is why I bought this thing here. This is an SMD soldering practice kit from Gikfun. And it is available from many different sellers, but I specifically chose the Gikfun version because one review on Amazon mentioned that it comes with a schematic. And obviously, if you want to make a working circuit, you really need a schematic. And indeed, it came with this piece of paper here, which has a schematic and lists all the components that are included in the kit, and even gives some tips on surface mount soldering. And the kit obviously includes the circuit board itself, which seems to be of pretty nice quality. And it also includes this bag with all the necessary components inside. As you can see, some of those components are really, really super tiny, because surface mount components come in different sizes. So for example, this is like, this size is called 1206. This size is called 0805. And these are relatively easy to solder. In comparison, 0603 is already quite challenging, and the smallest size 0402, well, looks like it's almost impossible to solder by hand, but we'll see about that. Obviously, I'm not going to try and solder this on camera, simply because it's really difficult to solder with when the camera is between myself and my work. So I will try to assemble this kit and then go back to you and show you what it looks like. But before I start, I will show you tools and materials that I'm going to use. Here you can see my soldering iron with the regular tip that I usually use for through-hole soldering, and this tip is definitely way too large for surface mount soldering. Instead, I will use this tip, which is many times smaller. Maybe even this tip is not small enough for the smallest SMD components, but we'll see about that. Obviously, I will also need some solder, and I will use this. This solder is 0.4 millimeters in diameter, so you can see how much finer this is compared to this thick solder. The solder already has flux in it, so it's a rosin core solder, but I will still use this flux here. And the final tool that I will use are these fine tweezers with bent tips that can be used for holding the components without obstructing my view. Thanks to the magic of filmmaking, the circuit is already assembled, and if I connect a 9-volt battery to it, you will see that it is actually working properly. And while my soldering will not win any prizes, it is probably good enough. At least the PCB worked on the first try, which was definitely a nice surprise. Frankly, the biggest challenge was not soldering per se, it was not losing any parts while working with them. And I actually managed to lose one of the SMD LEDs, that's why there is this big old through-hole LED sticking from the middle of the board. The only part that I did not enjoy was soldering the integrated circuits, but I actually managed to avoid creating any solder bridges. I guess I will buy a couple more soldering practice kits, and after that I will probably feel comfortable enough to tackle a real project with SMD parts.